What's cracking? Big dogs. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the headquarters. My name is Nicholas. This is BDGE Big Dogs. Gotta eat. And this is the first of two videos that we drop every Tuesday. Make sure you subscribe to tune in to the feature films every Tuesday. We are doing a running back waiver wire video for week 5 of fantasy football, which is what you're tuning into right now. And then after this, in a couple hours, we will drop the wide receiver slash this is a tight end week as well, because we got about 4 or 5 of them dudes scrapped up that we want to get onto our team. So just the pass catchers, we'll put it that way. Pass catchers will be in a couple hours. So again, make sure you subscribe so that you get a notification when that drops. This week, we've got a little interessante sauce that we could sprinkle on top of the waiver wire this week, because we've got some injuries to a couple starting running backs. Y'all know the deal. We're going to tuck our shirts in. Stop yelling. Let's eat. We also drop an in-depth waiver wire article and fab guidance article up on the membership website. If you are not already a member, a big dog or a goat member, head over to bdge.store/community. We'll be linked down below. That'll get you our waiver wire and fab guidance article. That'll get you access to our Q&Aassault, which is our private live stream every Saturday where you all can answer me your sit star questions. That gets our weekly in-season rankings. In the off-season, you'll get access to our dynasty and rookie rankings. You will also get access to BDGE Dynasty Startup Leagues in the offseason if y'all are trying to mess with the Dynasty Leagues. Got a lot of good shit going on the site. So bdge.store/community. Let's talk about the waiver wire. So the first big injury occurred in the Chicago Bears game. We got David Montgomery going down with what is believed to be a semi-minor knee injury. They wiped ACL off the table, so it doesn't look like it's going to be a season-long ending injury. It doesn't look like it's supposed to be that serious. What I've read about, I do know actually how to read despite popular belief. What I read online is not supposed to be too serious, probably an MCL sprain, some kind of knee sprain, which most of the time is not that big of a deal. We've seen a lot of running backs deal with MCL sprains over the last few years. Typically, it's 1-2 weeks, and by the third week or so, they're back, they're full strength. This is not an injury that typically lingers. This can be a grade 2 MCL sprain, though, if it's a more serious aspect to it. That will keep somebody usually out in the 3-6 week range. So we'll have to get more news on whether or not this is a grade 1 or grade 2. But again, this is not supposed to be too serious of an injury. So it's probably grade 1, which will be 1-2 weeks for David Montgomery. His backup, Mr. Damian Williams, will be like the every down player pretty much. He did bruise his quad, and that's also supposed to be a pretty non-serious injury. So if David Montgomery were to miss a couple weeks, you'd have Vegas in week 5, you'd have Green Bay in week 6, so neither of those are scary matchups for running backs. Damian Williams would probably be a nice little RB2 in your fantasy lineups. He's not someone I'm blowing the fab on, because again, David Montgomery will probably be back in a couple weeks, depending on severity. Y'all will probably know more about David Montgomery's injury by the time you tune in to this television show. If you're enjoying the show, or if you do enjoy the show, make sure you hit the thumbs up button right down below. Just scroll down. It just looks fucking just like that. All right, just click it. Just fucking click it. So Damian Williams would be the number one target for me. We also have another injury to a starting running back who I own way too much stock of, and that's Mr. Joe Mixon. Joe Mixon is dealing with some kind of ankle sprain. He suffered it in the Thursday night football game. They're talking about it's a low ankle sprain. It's a high ankle sprain of the low severity. They're just throwing around highs and lows right now. It's like Empire of the fucking Sun. It's not supposed to be that serious, but he's week to week, which does sound the alarms in my head, okay? The problem is, like, behind him, it's Samaje Perine, who has been out-snapping Chris Evans. In this week's game, when Joe Mixon was out, Samaje Perine out-snapped Chris Evans 16-2. So he's clearly the RB2 here. He's clearly the backup. However, I do think Chris Evans is going to play a pass-catching role in this Bengals offense if Joe Mixon misses time. I expect Joe Mixon to miss 1 week from everything I've read, from everything I've heard. Probably a 1 week absence, lengthiest 2 weeks. But even at that, this is not necessarily, you know, like Samaje Perine is going to, if he does what Joe Mixon does, you're getting 8 points in your lineup. And I expect it to be more of a committee with Perine and Chris Evans than it was with Joe Mixon and everybody else, because Joe Mixon was getting 80% of the touches, and that's probably not going to be the case for the backfield here in Cincinnati. They have on their schedule week 5, Green Bay, week 6, Detroit. So it is a nice little slate of games there. However, I expect this to be a high-scoring game in Green Bay. They're in Cincinnati, but against Green Bay. Should be a lot of passing volume there. I don't expect them to lean on the run. No reason to when they've got Joe Burrow heating up. Got Jamar Chase doing his thing. We've got Tyler Boyd heating up. T. Higgins should probably be bike soon. So Samaje Perine is not a guy I'm necessarily excited about. Might be like more of a desperate flex play if you want to. He'll probably get like 15 to 17 touches, which obviously you can do a lot worse, but he'll 0.2 yards per carry. He'll do exactly what Joe Mixon does. All right. And Chris Evans will take the pass catching work. So not too excited. A couple of guys that are most likely off your waiver wire, but they if they are available, you've got Latavius Murray and you've got James Conner. I think both of them are like flex plays. Both of them will get decent goal line work. They'll get the goal line work in their offense, but both of them have mobile quarterbacks who, you know, coin flip it out to see who actually ends up running it in for the touchdown. So in good game scripts, you're going to see a lot of Latavius Murray like we saw on Sunday. You're going to see a lot of James Conner like we saw on Sunday. If they get on the 1 or 2 yard line and they want to decide not to fuck around with the quarterback, then these guys are going to score the touchdowns. Latavius Murray, 18 carries. Tyson Williams, healthy scratch. I have no idea what they're doing, letting Le'Veon Bell and Devonta Freeman run around like a bunch of little fucking minions on the field. No need for that shit. Tyson Williams has been the best back, but he's a healthy scratch, so we're just going to follow what they're doing. Follow the actions. Not what they say. Watch what they do. Tyson Williams, healthy scratch, leads the way for Latavius Murray to be the guy here. So if Latavius Murray is available, you pick him up over James Conner. Okay, but James Conner also probably needs to be rostered because he's getting all the goal line work. Got 18 touches. I don't expect that to be the case most times, but he has a time and place in an offense that scores a whole lot of points. All right, three other backs I think you should probably have on your radar. You have Alex Collins, who's starting to eat in a little bit more into Chris Carson's workload. Looked very good on Sunday. Actually looked better than Chris Carson on Sunday, but like I'm not here to say Chris Collins, or I'm not here to say Alex Collins is better than Chris Carson. Man, that's a lot of fucking football action there. Chris Collins, Chris Carson, Alex Collins. What I could say is they all fucking stink for fantasy right now, all three of them. Now, Alex Collins actually looked pretty good on Sunday. Ripped in a 14-yard touchdown run, but like, you know, next week you can go 4 for 13 on the ground, and then you can drop him after that. So not a priority. Jeremy McNichols, also not a priority. I know you're going to see the box score, see that he led the Tennessee Titans in receiving work. Julio Jones and A.J. Brown, one of them will be back sooner rather than later, and I just don't think it's – I think Derrick Henry will continue to dominate that backfield. And it's just a one-off game where I don't expect McNichols to put up more than 3 or 4 catches a game if they continue to have no personnel to run out on the outside. So not getting too excited about him. PPR-wise, though, if I'm going to pick up a running back this week and he's kind of like off-kilter running back, it's going to be Brandon Bolden of the Patriots. We saw him take over the James White role. It was J.J. Taylor at first, lose a costly fumble. He's going to be in the doghouse for a century or so. So I expect Brandon Bolden to be the third down guy. I expect Damon Harris to bounce back, though. He will be a trade target for me. Damon Harris, 4 carries. Nobody else had more than 1 carry. Also caught 2 of 2 targets for 30 yards. Just an awful showing, but it was against the Buccaneers. So better days ahead for the Patriots backfield, but it looks like it's going to be split up between Damon Harris and Brandon Bolden going forward. So if you're deeper into PPR leagues, that's what you're looking at right now. So Damian Williams, Samaje Perine, James Conner, Latavius Murray, Alex Collins, Brandon Bolden, and not really Jeremy McNichols. But if you own Derrick Henry, maybe you want to roster McNichols as a handcuff or some shit like that. All right, so I want to get you a quick one out for today. If I missed anything, I apologize. These are usually like kind of off the rip based on all the research I did on Monday morning. I filmed these Monday afternoon. They go out Tuesday morning for y'all, as always. So again, if you want to continue to watch these, hit the subscription button down below. Thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. And go check out our community, bdge.store/community. Get you in the Discord. Get you yapping away with everybody else here. All right, we out of here. Peace.